ओम ज्ञानतिमिरान्धस्य ज्ञानाञ्जनशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः श्रीचैतन्यमनोभीष्टं स्थापितं येन भूतले स्वयं रूपकदा मह्यं ददाति स्वपदान्तिकं मुखं करोति वाचालम् पङ्गुं लङ्घयते गिरिं यत्कृपातमहं वन्दे श्रीगुरुं दीनतारणं श्रीचैतन्यईश्वरं परमानन्दमाधवं नमो विष्णुपादाय कृष्णप्रेष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदान्त स्वामी इति नामिने नमस्ते सारस्वतदेवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेषशून्यवादी पाश्चात्यदेशतारिणे वाञ्छाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्य एव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौर भक्त वृंद हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम हरे राम 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 हरे। इट इज माय ग्रेट pleasure, privilege and an honor to be here for the first of its very kind conference in the whole world, a conference on control rooms and control systems, I believe, and it gives me great pleasure to be amongst all of you here this morning to share a couple of thoughts on, as was announced, the inborn control system. First of all, I would like to express my sincerest and deepest gratitude to Sri Sunil Ji Ladda from Pride of Space Work Solutions and his whole team who have been chasing me on, you know, getting me here to be with all of you to share a couple of thoughts on this subject matter. In fact, I must at this confess. My confession is that I have no technical knowledge about these control systems and control rooms. And I'm here to inaugurate the whole conference on control rooms by talking on a subject called the inner control room. I'm an electrical engineer by profession. I worked with Hewlett Packard, HP, before I became a monk. And although I'm an electrical engineer, after 21 years of being away from technical subjects, I'm not sure if I can say anything at all about the technicalities of the control rooms. I'm sure a lot of that will come through the day for all of you, which is going to be of a lot of relevance for all of you here. But I must say that we engineers always look at finding solutions to problems that never existed. One of my friends in the engineering college where I studied, he used to live in a dormitory in a hostel, and because there's a lot of mosquitoes there, he would sleep in a mosquito net. One morning this guy got up and he saw that he was bitten by a mosquito. So he was thinking, man, I was sleeping inside a mosquito net. How did this mosquito bite me? How did it get in here? So he started exploring it and he found there's a hole in the mosquito net. So the mosquito had entered in through the hole and bitten this guy. So this guy thought, well, now I'm an engineer. I must find a solution to this problem. What do I do? I don't know how to sew. I don't have a needle, I don't have a thread, but I am an engineer. How do I solve this problem? So this gentleman made another hole right next to the hole which was in the mosquito net and put a pipe from one hole to the other hole. So the mosquito comes in from one side of the hole, goes through the pipe and goes out from the other side of the hole. I must tell you something, a lot of out-of-box thinking, you know. A lot of out-of-box thinking. Well, these technicalities are beyond me, the engineer technicalities, but I'm here to speak about life. And I'm here to speak about the inborn control room within all of us. That control room, which when put in place, the outside control rooms will automatically fall in place. As we look at conquering outer space, there is a great need that we learn also how to conquer inner space. Because as we conquer inner space, our conquest of outer space becomes much easier, much effective, and much sustainable as well. So I thought I would talk a little bit about this subject matter. How many of you flew into Udaipur? Loads of you. How many of you enjoy flying? I don't see any hands up there. I can't see much, but yeah, I see a couple of hands up there. I've become a bird, you know, I'm most of the time in the air. So I'm constantly traveling and so many times just flying, that flying is like a hassle to me now, you know. I was once flying from Moscow in Russia to Kiev in Ukraine. And it was an Aeroflot airline. As I boarded the airline, the stewardess came up to me and said, "Welcome on board, sir. We guarantee takeoff." I said, "Madam, what about landing?" She said, "You'll have to pray to the Almighty for that." I'll tell you, when we talk about takeoff, it's completely beyond our control. It's not in our control. It's in the control of the pilot, not in our control. And when we talk about landing, even landing is not in our control. It's in the control of the pilot. Once you pay for an airline ticket, you board the flight, both the takeoff and the landing are out of your control. You know what are the three things that people are scared of the most? Number one, death. Number two, public speaking. Scared of facing an audience. And number three, the fear of flying. It's a statistic, people fear flying. I guess that's why they call an airport a terminal. They're so scared of flying, you know. And I see when the plane lands, people will grab onto their seat as if now they'll be safe if something happens. But I must tell you something. When we talk about takeoff and landing, both are beyond our control. What is in our control, however, is the choices we make when we are on the flight. Someone can just choose to go to sleep. Someone can choose to eat. Someone can choose to drink. Someone can choose to chat. Someone can choose to network. Someone can choose to watch movies. Someone can choose to read an interesting book. Although the takeoff and landing are completely beyond our control, the choices we make on the flight are completely within our control. Ladies and gentlemen, I think life is like a flight from destination B to destination D, where destination B stands for birth. And there, we have absolutely no control. How many of you chose your parents? Please raise your hands. How many of you chose the country of your birth? Please raise your hands. How many of you chose your looks? Please raise your hands. None. Birth, completely beyond our control. And that's a takeoff. For the flight, the takeoff is birth, but for that flight, the landing is death, which is also absolutely beyond our control, and it must happen. One 65-year-old lady, she used to always nudge her 25-year-old nephew. Whenever there was a wedding in the family, she would tell her 25-year-old nephew, "Agla tera number hai, beta. Agla tera number hai." And when we fly in this journey, the turbulence around is also beyond our control. You can't control the takeoff, you can't control the landing, you can't control the turbulence, can you? You can't control your death, you can't control a lot of the situations that come to your life. Can you? All this turbulence that disturbs you, have any of you ever been disturbed in your minds? I once read a guy's t-shirt slogan, it said, "Please do not disturb," small lines. And underneath in large letters was written, "Already disturbed." when I'm so already disturbed, what's the point of disturbing me? You know, these factors like turbulence are beyond our control. But in this journey of life, what we can control is our choices. This inner control room, this inborn control room, is something that dictates the quality of our life. Nothing external can change the quality of our life. What can truly change the quality of our life is how we control our inborn control rooms by making proper choices. And therefore they say, being born a male is a matter of birth. Being a man is a matter of age. But being a gentleman is a matter of choice. And as a corollary to that, being a female is a matter of birth. Being a woman is a matter of age. But being a gentle woman is a matter of choice. Ladies and gentlemen, when we talk about this inborn control room, we talk about the greatest asset that each human is gifted with. The ability to choose. The ability to change the quality of life that we are all leading. I thought this morning I would talk to you about a few secrets or a few sutras in terms of these choices that we make. How many of you are born here? I'm sorry, it's such a rhetorical question, isn't it? How many of you are born? What a stupid question that is. Sometimes people get so many children. One American couple gave birth to twins, you know, girls. So the wife asked the husband, what will we name them? The husband said, girls, right? I like Indian names. We'll name them Tara and Sitara. They're pretty names, wow. Then the next time they gave birth to children, again twins. This time boys now. The wife said, what do we name them now? The husband said, Peter and Repeater. The third time they gave birth, again they gave birth to twins, two boys again. The wife said, what do we name them now? The husband said, Max and Climax. The fourth time they gave birth to children, again twins, boys, eight of them now. The wife said, what now? The husband said, stop and full stop. No more children, that's enough. Well, a part of life, birth. How many of you went to school? I'm sorry. I asked such stupid rhetorical questions, you know. I'm sorry about that. And you go to school, and in school, I must tell you, this exams and spellings and pronunciations, you remember your teachers correcting you in your spellings and your pronunciations? One teacher asked the student, which state of India are you from? The guy said, Maharashtra. The teacher said, can you spell it for me? He said, I'm from Goa, madam. Sorry, I'm not from Maharashtra. Maharashtra to spell such a large, huge word is too much, you know. Goodness mine. A teacher once called a father and said to him, hey, I've been trying to teach your son how to pronounce the word electricity last 1 week, but he keeps saying electricity. What do I do? The father said, what can my poor son do? That is his capacity, you know. He can't cope more than that. I must tell you, those spellings, those pronunciations, school life. How many of you went to college and university? Did professional courses? Of course, most all of you. And to get admission in such colleges, God. In India, to get admission in a good college, a good university, IITs and IIMs, goodness, you really work hard. One guy was filling his admission form to get into an MBA course in a college. And he was standing right at the entrance gate, and the watchman was standing there. He asked the watchman, kaisa hai bhai sahab college, kaisa hai MBA ke liye form bhar raha hu. Bola, bahut acha college hai, maine MBA idhar se kiya, tu bhi aa ja. You also come, I passed my MBA out of here, you join me as well. And then after college, work. How many of you work? Of course, all of you. How many of you run businesses? Of course, all of you. And what do you do it for? Charity? Money. Money, ladies and gentlemen. Money. God, they say money is sweeter than honey. Oops. And if you're a Marwadi, God,
I'm from a Marwadi Jain family. You know, your business sense is so astute. You don't have to go to business school if you're a Marwadi. One Chinese man and a Marwadi man were traveling on a local train in Mumbai, and a mosquito sat on a Chinese man's head. He picked it up and he ate it. Then a mosquito sat on the Marwadi man's head. He picked it up and said, "Kharidega kya?" A Marwadi man will start business with mosquitoes, I must tell you. You're born, you go to school, you go to university and college, you start working, you earn money. And what's the next step? Marriage. What a control room, isn't it? What a control room. God, whose control works is kind of really powerful. One man, a CEO of a company, his employees were telling him, "Sir, you're such a lion here at work. You're a lion at home as well." He said, "Yeah, I'm a lion at home, but there Durga Devi sits on a Trishul, with a Trishul in her hand on top of me, you know. I must tell you." How many of you men feel your wives control you? Raise your hands. You may have run big control rooms. I can't see. Let me see the hands raised. Some guys who have come with their wives are looking at their wives. Shall I raise my hand, please? And the guys who have come alone are with great courage raising their hands. I must tell you, for sure, you know, we're talking about going through life, marriage, and then a family, from birth till that destination, as life ends. Shall I say something? In our life, we have learned only how to go through it. We don't learn how to grow through it. Life is not meant just to go through. Life is meant to grow through. And in the process of going through, we forget growing through. One of the most popular actors in India, Bollywood actors, is Hrithik Roshan. And Hrithik Roshan is considered as one of the most ideal male figures in terms of his body, in terms of his bodily proportions in Bollywood. It's considered like an adorable male figure. Now, one of my friends in Bollywood told me something interesting. He said, "With Hrithik Roshan, looks great, acts great, and is a fantastic person, fantastic gentleman. There's one issue. Such an amazing face, such an amazing body, such an amazing actor. There's one issue. He has a massive problem in his spine, a massive problem in his back. His back hurts. Two of his discs practically are dislocated. And ladies and gentlemen, do you know why? Do you know why this happened? Because in trying to work out his upper body, to get those large biceps, to get this 8-pack abs, to get the deltoids, and to make sure all of his upper body parts are great in the looks, he forgot, or probably he didn't prioritize, working out on his lower body, his glutes, his quadriceps, his hamstrings. These things are not seen. On the screen, no actor pulls out his trousers and says, "Hey, look at my hamstrings, they're so good, yeah?" No cinema actor will pull up his trouser and say, "Did you see my quadriceps? Such strong quadriceps, yeah?" And surely no other actor is going to show his glutes saying, "Look how I worked on my glutes and they're so strong." No one does that. What do people work on? What is seen to the world. What is seen to the world? Remove your shirt on the screen, the biceps are seen. What is seen to the world? Remove your shirt and the triceps are seen. What is seen to the world? Take your shirt off and your 8-pack abs are seen. Remove your shirt and what is seen to the world? Your trapezius is seen. And in working on what is seen, if you forget to work on what is not seen, this growth is not sustainable. That growth which is not seen sustains the growth that is seen to the world. Ladies and gentlemen, your external growth is seen to the world. People see your cars, they don't see your mind. People see your gadgets, they don't see your mind. People see your fancy homes, they don't see your mind. People see your designer garments, they don't see your mind. People see your skill sets, they don't see your mind. People see your abilities, they don't see your mind. In trying to just work on what is seen by the world, if we forget to work on what is not seen by the world, our condition will be exactly like Hrithik Roshan, where we will suffer unsustainable pain in our lives, you know? And thus, it's very crucial. As you work on the control systems outside, there's a great need that you work on the control systems inside. Externals are seen, internals are not. One of my friends in Mumbai is a Gujarati fellow, very wealthy guy. He purchased a Lamborghini. Now, a Lamborghini is a very expensive car, ladies and gentlemen. I was in New York recently. I live in Manhattan when I'm in New York, and Manhattan is the most expensive part of the world. Most wealthy people live in Manhattan. And I hardly saw Lamborghinis there. And here in Mumbai, this friend of mine purchased a Lamborghini, and he's Gujarati. So from the showroom, he called him and said, Prabhuji, pagla karenge? Maine kaha, bhai dunya pagli hai, aur kisko pagla karenge? I didn't understand what pagla meant. Then he said, in Gujarati, pagla means blessing the car, touching your feet to the car. Ghar ka pagla kijiye, car ka pagla kijiye. Pagla means touching your feet, blessing the car. So I said to him, are bhai, Lamborghini hai na? Kyon nahi karenge pagla bhai, le aao. Hum sadhuon ko Lamborghini ka pagla karne kab milega? You come. So the guy came to our temple. And he said to me, we'll go for a 15 minutes drive, a 15 minutes blessing drive. I was on a blessing drive, pagla drive. And as we went off for the drive, the car stopped at a traffic light in a place in Mumbai called Pedder Road. And as the car was at the traffic light, one guy was in some other car there, old modeled car. He turned around. And his eyes grew big when he saw the slick yellow Lamborghini, posh car in Mumbai. Wow. And his eyes grew even bigger when he saw me inside the car. And you should have seen the expression on his face. The expression on his face were like, kya Swamiji, aap bhi aap? I wanted to open the windshield and tell him, mere bhai, gaadi meri nahi hai, main pagla hoon jo pagla karne baitha hai. This car is not mine. Relax, chill. Then, the car took off. The 15 minutes drive had turned out to be a 35 minutes drive. Ladies and gentlemen, after 35 minutes, I told this friend of mine, I said to him, look, I have a very important meeting to attend back in our temple. Can we drive back now? What this man did shocked me to the core. What this man did will probably shock you to the core. As soon as I suggested we need to get back and I need to go back for the meeting, this friend of mine started crying like a baby. Those weren't tears of joy. Tears of anger. How many of you seated here in this August assembly today would cry tears of anguish and agony on the day that you get possession of a slick yellow Lamborghini and you're driving it for the first time? Who will cry? This guy was crying. You know, how do you distinguish between tears of joy and tears of pain? The temperature. The tears of joy, they're cool. Tears of anguish and pain are warm. Next time if someone is crying, don't take a thermometer to check whether it's happy or sad. You know, his tears are warm. Don't do that. As I sat there in the car, I told him to take the car to the sidewalk and said, let's park. What happened? It took me about 10 minutes to get him to speak. And when I did ask him what happened, he said, just 3 days back, my wife has filed papers for divorce. I love her. My children love her. We don't want to let her go. I've tried whatever I could to keep her, hold her. She doesn't listen. What should I do? And he started crying again. And I was thinking to myself, a plush, slick, yellow Lamborghini, which the world seeks, couldn't do anything to uplift his mind. Couldn't do anything to pick up his spirits. Couldn't do anything at all to bring any hope in his heart. He was sitting in this plush Lamborghini, ladies and gentlemen. But when the inner control room is out of order, no matter where you are, life is a mess. You can never experience life to its fullest unless your inner control room, your mind is with you. As soon as the state of that mind is altered, the state of that mind is disturbed, nothing outside can bring hope. People are in the best homes, people are in the best cars, they're in the best jobs, they're dressed in the best outfits, they're at the best social events and parties, and are a nervous wreck. Can you believe that? Can you believe that? Take charge of your life. Use your choice to try and deal with that inner control room. Because only when you deal with that inner control room will you experience life to its fullest. Not just that, your effectivity, your efficiency, your productivity in whatever you do will increase multifold. Is Google crazy? Is Google headquarters crazy in giving their employees such an incredible work atmosphere where they can relax, they can chill, they can swim, they can play, they can do in a very informal work atmosphere? Because when the inner control room is relaxed, the productivity, the efficiency, and the effectiveness of what we do is enhanced to another level. You know, when I studied at the College of Engineering, Pune, I remember our college canteen, the college mess, which is in a mess most times, was very well known for samosas. So one day, four of us friends were sitting in the college canteen. The canteen was on the banks of a river. It was a very beautiful place. We were sitting on the banks of the river on the lawns. We had ordered 4 plates of samosa. And as all 4 of us were sitting there, one of our friends came across and said, "Hey, you know what? We said what?" Said, "Our results are out." And you know in India how results are so big. How many of you parents think that your kids really need to bring good results? Academics? All Indian parents. One guy was walking with his father, college going boy, and his friend sent him a text message. The text message read, "Today's our results." The guy replied back, "Look man, I'm walking with my dad, and dad can pick up the phone anytime and he'll come to know what you're saying. So we'll use a code language, yeah? If I fail in one subject, say good morning to you, I'll understand. If I fail in 2 subjects, say good morning to you and dad, I'll understand." 5 minutes later, there was a message, "Good morning to you, dad, family and friends." All subject goodness. I'll tell you something, in India, results is indeed a big thing. So as we were sitting there, this friend of mine was like hyper that day. Before the samosa came, he said, "Oh, look at this weather, such great weather today, wow." And then he said, "Oh wow, look at the beautiful ripples on the river. Wow, what a day, amazing day." And then the samosa came. This guy was so hyper that day. Wow, wow, he picked up the samosa, took the first bite. And as he took the first bite, he shouted, "Wow, wow, this is the best samosa I've had in my life." And I'm kind of, "Okay, buddy, what's the big thing?" And then this friend came and said, "You know what?" I said, "What?" "Our results are out." This guy said, "What happened to my results?" He said, "You failed in 3 subjects. The weather was the same. The ripples of the river were the same. Half the samosa was still in his hand. But now he was seeing his father's face inside the samosa. That evening I have to meet him and give the report to my father that I failed my exams." I'll tell you, as soon as the state of mind is altered, nothing outside starts making sense. When you're at work, you carry the anxieties of home. When you're at home, you carry the anxieties of work. Is our life and our mind only meant to carry anxieties? How many of you flew in IndiGo? If you flew in IndiGo Airlines, you will see right at the door of the cockpit is written, "Flying is a serious profession. Please do not carry your worries beyond this point." I'll tell you, such is life. When our inner control system is not right, ladies and gentlemen, it is definitely very hard to lead a contented, productive, and an effective life. I think therefore Sunil ji did very well by saying that the first topic we should have here is the inborn control system, because if this is not in order, nothing's in order. People who are out of balance inside, people who are lost inside, depressed inside, irritable inside, can never do good at work, can never do good at anything. They can never lead a wholesome life for that matter, you know. Okay, now let me ask a question to all of you ladies here. How many of you used to play with dolls? Okay. Can I ask a question to all of you gentlemen here? How many of you would play with toy cars? Hot Wheels, little toy cars? It's quite funny. Girls play with dolls and guys play with cars. When they grow up, suddenly the guys start playing with dolls. And looks like the girls start playing with cars, you know. My God. I'll tell you something. How many of you ladies have brought your dolls here today for this conference? And after the talk, you come and introduce, Prabhuji, look at my dolly. She also came for the conference. Prabhuji, do you mind blessing my dolly? How many of you guys brought your tiny cars here today? None of you. How many of you would say, can I drop you to the airport in my Hot Wheels, Swamiji? We'll take you to the Udaipur airport in our little Hot Wheels. That doll which mattered to you so much when you were a child, that car which mattered to you so much when you were a child, doesn't even matter to you today because you have grown up. When you grow up, all those things, small things that mattered to you then, don't matter to you any longer, ladies and gentlemen. And therefore, if small things matter to you a lot, he said this, she said this, the turbulence in the flight, this is what's happening. I lost my job. I lost my stakes in the stock market. When the small and the big things start mattering a lot to you, we have to know one thing. We're not sufficiently grown up. If we were sufficiently grown up internally, like when you're grown up, those dolls and those toys don't matter to you because you've grown up. Similarly, things around us will not matter to us as much if we grow up. Therefore, I've been saying, life is not meant just to go through. It is meant to grow through. Without that internal growth, all the turbulence in the journey of our life, all those dodgy things that happen, affect us a lot. We get frustrated, we get angry, we get anxious, we get depressed, and a whole range of negative emotions in this inner control system called the mind. I'm sorry to say, that's not what life is meant for, isn't it? And thus, we need to definitely take charge of this control system. How many of you expressed your anger? Expressed it through pure Sanskrit vocabulary? You know, in Sanskrit, a donkey is called Vaishakhanandan. What a name, isn't it? Sanskrit. So next time you call someone a donkey, you say, hey, Vaishakhanandan. That person will probably think that you're composing poetry and, you know, hey, Vaishakhanandan. It's a very polished way of calling someone a donkey, an ass. You know, one lady, how anger and frustration comes out is unbelievable, isn't it? Have any of you been irritable at work? Okay. Have any of you been irritable at how home? The mind and the inner control system is out of order, and how it will come forth in language and action can be really unpleasant many times. One man asked his wife, when you're really, really mad at me, really angry at me, what do you do to vent out your anger on me? She said, I clean the toilet. I clean the commode. He said, how does cleaning the toilet vent out your anger on me? She said, I clean it with your toothbrush. You know, so the next morning you have some special effects when you start brushing your teeth. I must say something. All those little and big things that make us mad will not make us mad when we grow up internally. Just like if someone takes your little doll away now, you wouldn't bother much. If someone takes away your little Hot Wheel cars now, you wouldn't bother much because you have grown up. Similarly, internal growth is a must to handle that turbulence in the journey, in that flight, and the turbulence will happen. I must give you a quick formula for that internal growth. Ladies and gentlemen, believe me, hand on my heart, this formula is very powerful. It has changed my life, It will hopefully change yours if practiced. Very powerful. Whether it's your work, whether it's your relationships, whether whatever it is, try and apply this and you will see how life transforms and changes. As a return gift from my side, Gaur Gopal Das from ISKCON Chowpatty, as a return gift to all of you at Confess 16, I want to offer you a car. I want to offer you a car. Nowadays car, you know that movie Deewar? In that movie Deewar, there was, you know, a dialogue, mere paas gaadi hai, mere paas bangla hai, mere paas paisa hai, tere paas kya hai? You know what he said? Mere paas maa hai. In Bombay, the dialogue has changed now. The guy is saying, mere paas Jaguar hai, mere paas Bentley hai, mere paas Mercedes hai, mere paas BMW hai, mere paas Audi hai, tere paas kya hai? The guy said, mere paas parking space hai. In Mumbai, to get parking space, I must tell you, is such a challenge. To get parking space in Mumbai is definitely a massive challenge. I want to offer you this car. It's not a Bentley. It's not a Jaguar. It's not a BMW. It's not an Aston Martin. And I've driven each one of them. When I travel in the world, I've driven each one of these cars. Fancy car, you know, absolutely fancy car, even a Lamborghini. But the car that I'm offering all of you today is a car, if lived by, will change your life because you will grow internally. The C in the car stands for change what is changeable. Certain things are in your control. Someone asked me, what's the difference between, your choice and destiny? I said, your height is your destiny, your weight is your choice. You know? Change what is changed. Can you change your heights? Can you change your complexion? Maybe with a facelift, plastic surgery, with a lot of artificial things. Can you change these things easily? Can you change your weight? I think so. I told one of my friends, itna mota ho gaya, to thoda vajan kam kar mere bhai. He said, nahin, nahin. Vajan kam karke kya karna hai? वजन कम करके क्या करना है? आखिर सबको एक दिन मरना है, इसीलिए अभी जो भी खाना है खा लो मेरे दोस्त, क्योंकि अगले जन्म में फिर 3 किलो से ही शुरू करना है। I said, what audacity, you know, what a couple of guys formed on not wanting to exercise and control his diet. There are certain things within your control. Change what is changeable. Even in people around you, change what is changeable. Within your spouses and relationships, there will be certain things that are changeable. Change what is changeable. At your workplace, change what is changeable. But there are certain things that are not changeable. Therefore, the A in the car stands for accept what is unchangeable. Ladies and gentlemen, if you don't learn how to accept things that are beyond your control system is out of order. You're constantly being troubled in your mind. In the last 25 years of my life, I have suffered from pain in my temples 24 hours a day. I have excruciating pain here 24 hours a day, 25 years. Do I look like I have that pain? Did I show you that I have that pain? What did I do? Change what is changeable. I tried allopathy, I tried naturopathy, I tried homeopathy, I even tried Tirupathy. All pathies I tried. When it didn't work, then I have to come to the second level. Accept what is unchangeable. Ladies and gentlemen, evolved life begins by accepting this fact that not everything is in our control. In terms of work and systems, yes, we can put things in place. But in terms of relationships and situations, not everything can be in our control. My father, he died in the year 2009 of Parkinson's disease. Wonderful gentleman. I was born in the Marwadi Jain family, as I said to you. I travel a lot internationally. In fact, I'm traveling to Germany the day after tomorrow, Germany and Poland. And that year, every year I spent a month in the UK, in London. This year, in fact, I spoke at the British Parliament. I was invited to give a talk at the House of Commons. And as I was there in the UK, just before I left for London, I saw my dad. He was bedridden. I brought him some hope. I said a few good things to him. After I got back from London, one morning as I was resting, 1:30 in the morning, I received a call from my mother. That day my phone was on for some reason. As I received this call, my mother was crying on the phone. She couldn't even speak. I guessed what had happened. Finally, she broke open and she said, "Your father's left. My lifelong partner, your father's gone." I drove to Pune from Mumbai, where my parents live. 2.5 hours drive, 3 hours drive. It was raining. As I came there, we took my father's body to the crematorium. It was a small one, a stage like this. My father's body was kept here. About 40, 50 people there in the gathering. Some family, some friends, some community members. And one gentleman who was the leader of our community and who also happened to be close family to me, he comes up to stage and he said, "Mr. Such and Such, he was such a nice gentleman. You know how life is so funny, isn't it? When you're born, people love you. And when you die, people love you. In between, you have to manage. When you're born, people will say good things about you. When you die, people will say good things about you. In between, you have to manage how people will say, have good impressions about you." He said some good things about my father. And then he said, "Actually, the cause of this man's death is his son. That's me." Has any of you here gone through such an insult where you're called the killer of your father? I'll tell you, I was annoyed. I was angry. But the occasion was very sober. Plus, I now put this dress. I didn't want to kind of say anything and react to what he had said. I was very upset though. I came back to my mother's house. That night, as I slept, tossing and turning, there was only one line that kept ringing in my control system inside, in my control room. I couldn't sleep because my control room was out of order. Everything outside, the air conditioning temperature was perfect, the bed was soft, everything was perfect, but I couldn't sleep because my control room was out of order. The only one line that was ringing in my mind again and again and again was, this man who had the guts to say this line, not having understood, not having seen what was the background to my father's death, not having understood what I had done for my father's health, not having understood that I got the best doctors from the country and the world across for my father. What did this guy know? Nothing. And yet he spoke. And I'm sure all of you go through situations like these. May not be extreme ends like this, but all of you go through situations of your own kinds. Isn't it? And here I am. Only this one line ringing in my mind again and again. I couldn't sleep. And it's not now. I've been in Hare Krishna, I've been chanting and practicing the spirituality for a while. This is 2009, a few years back. I've been with this for 21 years as a monk. Disturbed my mind, couldn't sleep. And then a statement came to my mind, which gave me peace. It will give you peace. Please, please, do not ever allow any individual to remote control your emotions. People press the remote control and make you feel trashed. And people press the remote control and make you feel good. To feel good, you depend on others. And to feel bad, you depend on others. Do you, ladies and gentlemen, realize here that people around are holding the remote control of your control room and are pressing the triggers and making you feel good or bad? One lady, it was a wedding anniversary, the husband came back home and the husband said, "I got a very special anniversary gift for you." She said, "What is that gift?" He said, "You are A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K." She said, "What?" He said, "You're A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K." He said, "What do you mean?" The husband said, "You are A for adorable, B for beautiful, C for charming, D for dexterous, E for enchanting. And now she was thinking, I've never received a gift like that. Say, E for enchanting. F for fashionable. G for gorgeous. H for humble. And he felt quiet. She said, but you said till K, right? What about IJK? He said, I am just kidding. With all of those other qualities that I mentioned, you know, I am just kidding that you are adorable, you are beautiful, you are enchanting. I'll tell you, people praise you, they press the button and make you feel, hey, adorable, enchanting, beautiful, gorgeous, fashionable, dexterous, humble, and then they press the button. I am just kidding. Crashed inside, depressed, frustrated, angry. If you guys come and tell me, what a lecture, Swamiji, what a fantastic talk, and if I start using that as a trigger to make myself feel good, tomorrow you will say, what a horrible talk, and then I feel trashed. Ladies and gentlemen, don't derive your self-worth from what others say of you. Don't give the remote control of your emotions to anyone. Don't you allow any damned person in this world to play with your emotions by controlling that remote control outside. Take charge of the control room for yourself. Take charge of your feelings. Take charge of your emotions. And don't allow any person to disturb the peace, the joy, and the contentment of your mind and your heart. I remember I slept. Because what do? Change what is changeable? Accept what is unchangeable. Can people change? Can I stop that guy from talking what he talks? Can you guys stop anyone talking behind your back? Do you have control over others? Do you have control over what people are talking about you? Do I have control over what you're talking about me? No. Therefore, learn to accept what is unchangeable. Acceptance is a very powerful tool for peace. If you don't accept, God, it's trouble. Are you all with me, by the way? I'm just ending in 5 minutes. So in the car, the C stands for change what is changeable. The A stands for accept what is unchangeable. Ladies and gentlemen, and there are certain things which are not even acceptable. Therefore, the R in the car stands for remove yourself from the unacceptable. I know a lady in Mumbai, 25 years old, nice lady. She got married. Within 6 months' time, she found that her husband is a gay. I'm not for or against. This is not the topic we are discussing. I'm not talking about homosexuality, for or against. That's not the subject. And I'm not giving any opinion on it. I'm just saying, she got married to this guy. In 6 months, she found out he's a gay. He had an affair with 3 men. He brought them home. What should she do? Change the changeable? What should she do? Accept the unchangeable? She had only one thing left. To remove herself from the unacceptable. Again, this is not an opinion I'm making for her. It was not an acceptable thing. They parted. Many times in life, we cannot physically remove ourselves from the unacceptable. At that time, we have to learn how to mentally remove ourselves from the unacceptable. While being there. While being there, you have to learn how to withdraw. You have to take charge of your control room. Wo chilla rahe hain, cheekh rahe hain, kaam mein politics kar rahe hain, phir bhi humko seekhna padega kaise apne aap ko andar kiche. Kyunki humko change the changeable nahi kar sakte logon ko. Aap accept the unchangeable bhi nahi kar pa rahe. To ek hi vikalp hai aapke paas. Remove yourself from the unacceptable. Wo bhi physically nikal nahi sakte. To ek hi vikalp bacha. Remove yourself from the unacceptable. Internally, ladies and gentlemen. And that's why in order to do that, spirituality becomes such an incredible, essential thing. Spirituality then is not just an option, spirituality becomes a necessity. Because how do you get that inner strength, that inner growth to remove yourself? It is only possible by properly connecting ourselves to that source of strength by which we can grow internally. Therefore, I always say, don't just go through life, grow through life. And if you want to grow through life, drive this car. If you drive this car,
I'll tell you, life will indeed be different. Otherwise, yes, we are going around like the Lamborghini, inside the Lamborghini, but there's going to be something at all points of time to keep our minds disturbed. Ladies and gentlemen, as we take control of our control rooms internally, I'm sure we'll be able to take control of the control rooms externally. We'll be able to experience a more wholesome, peaceful, happy life, and we'll also be able to contribute in terms of our work, in terms of our efficiency, our productivity, our effectiveness, because one who's peaceful, one who's happy, one who's contented, does more than a person who's disturbed, who's depressed, who's irritable, who's frustrated. And thus I say, there is nothing like the inborn control room which the Creator created within all of us. And as this is in place, everything else is in place. If this is not in place, even if everything else is in place, the experience of life is completely different. And therefore I wish to thank Sri Sunilji Latta and Pyro Space for having invited me over for this morning's Confess 2016. And I thank you all very, very much for your kind attention whilst I was giving you these thoughts. To summarize what we have discussed, we can go through life, different phases of life, but if we don't grow through life, the small and the big things will affect us, like the toy cars and the toy dolls will affect us when we are not grown up. And the internal principle for growth is the principle of car. Change what is changeable, accept what is unchangeable, and remove yourself from the unacceptable. And believe me, if you only work on what is seen and not work on what is not seen, our condition will be like Hrithik Roshan in terms of our backs. Therefore, as you work on the control systems and the control rooms outside, make sure that you spend some quality time to also deal with your control rooms inside. And that's precisely what the path of spirituality is. I wish to thank all of you very, very much for your kind attention. Thank you very much.
Thank you.